What's up, guys? Robbie Reyes here. Welcome to the Roads to Andromeda gameplay series. Taking a look at all the Mass Effect 3 multiplayer characters, my preferred builds, gameplay, and discussing what we can't wait to see in Mass Effect Andromeda. Okay, we got here the human male soldier. Female and male are the same. This guy really, in the beginning, he was not a very good character, and he slowly became really, really good from the buffs. Primarily to frag grenade. A lot of early on in the game, a lot of these grenades weren't very good, and then they slowly buffed them. And the biggest thing that they had going for them was this gear that came out, grenade capacity. So that really made these grenade classes really good. Okay, the human soldier. I don't go for concussive shot. There are some awesome builds using concussive shot because it's. I might do one for you, but for this is the standard kind of soldier build I like to do, and it's really, really good. Adrenaline rush, go damage, melee damage, because we don't want this power to last long. We want to be able to spam it. And shield boost. So this is good. You know, you get a little bit of your shield back, and you do a little more damage. The melee isn't so you can run around meleeing. It's just so that you get a little bit more weapon damage and your shield back. And it's a good amount of weapon damage. I mean, take a look at this. We're looking at 70% weapon damage. It's almost like a tactical cloak. All right, frag grenade. This wrecks. Look at that damn number right there. Damage. We're going to go damage, bleed damage, and armor piercing. In this game, typically, the biggest bars of health are going to be armor. So oftentimes, it's best to go, you know, increase your damage against armor. And we're not going to go shield overload. You'll see when I'm fighting big groups of Cerberus or, you know, Geth or Collectors or whatever, the barriers and shields, they don't last. So, you know, why not just get more armor damage when you get the big groups of Scions or Brutes or Ravagers? Okay, we're going to go power damage, and weapon damage. Primarily, you're going to be finding big groups of enemies and spamming your grenades. But in addition to that, you're going to be adrenaline rushing and shooting enemies. You don't have a good stun power to make it easier to shoot enemies, like an energy drain or a, you know, reeve or whatever. No instant power on this build. You could do concussive shot. That helps you a little bit. But that power takes time to travel, and it doesn't do as good a job as an instant power like energy drain or, you know, overload. We're going to go into all health and shields, obviously. Okay. Getting into the weapons. This is where I kind of... This is where this kind of a build is going to help you. Because when I design these builds, I'd make it so that you can use it playing gold, unknown, unknown. And platinum, of course. But my point is, it works against all the enemy factions, from the equipment down to the weapons. So the weapons I'm going to choose are going to be the Harrier and the Geth Plasma Shotgun. Why? Because when you're host, it is a bitch to kill Phantoms. If you don't have a stagger power, or if you don't have something, it's not easy. And that'll get you killed a lot. Geth Plasma Shotgun staggers the Phantom and does a ton of damage to them. So, I mean, this, literally when I'm playing in Cerberus, on Phantom Heavy Waves, you'll see me put the Harrier away and keep the Geth Plasma out the entire wave almost. Maybe pull up the Harrier if I have to kill an Atlas quickly. But against Reapers, against the Collectors, against Geth, I'm never going to take out the Geth Plasma Shotgun. Never. And this is the beauty of not going into Concussive Shot, because the recharge time is supposed to be very small in Concussive Shot. But on a guy that's taking this many heavy weapons, it's going to be long, so we don't want it. We just want our adrenaline rush, which is already is only at a 4.4 recharge time, and you know that's pretty small. And it duration is 5.2 seconds, so you're not getting any benefit from getting that recharge time any further down. You are stuck with it for 5.2 seconds. Do you see what I'm saying? So it doesn't matter if this recharge speed was lower than that. As long as that duration is on, you can't apply the power again. So we're in the sweet spot here. The moral of the story is you can go heavy on this guy if you don't go concussive shot. So Harrier and Geth Plasma. unfortunately, we're going to have to use armor-piercing rounds on this guy. I would like to have some, and you'll notice, like, when we're playing, if I'm shooting at something with a barrier or a shield, it does take quite a bit of time to get it down. But, you know, the armor-piercing is going to help you really shred the bosses, and this is kind of my point. With this guy, you're going to open with the grenades a lot. You'll see a big group of enemies, phantoms, whatever, you know. Your opener is often going to be just a ton of grenades. Whatever's left standing, you're going to adrenaline rush and shoot the shit out of with your weapon of choice. And I'm definitely recommending the Harrier. Remember, anytime you use the Harrier on a grenade class, you're getting a semi-buff to the Harrier, because running to the boxes to get ammo means you're always getting ammo for your Harrier too. So they work hand in hand. Cyclonic on this guy. I wish they would have buffed this guy, this human soldier, and just given him, even the human vanguard, just given him a little bit more health and shields than the other base human class. Like, why does the human vanguard and human soldier not have more health and shields than the engineer and infiltrator? It doesn't make any sense. Like, they should have done something. But you could argue that, oh, well, they have biotic charge and adrenaline rush, so that's their little bit tanky edge over the infiltrator and engineer. But in my opinion, they should have given him a little bit more. So we're going to go Cyclonic. You could go Power Up, you could go Adrenaline. Adrenaline would be great to get the nade box fast, get to the spawns quickly. Could go Power Up, but remember, we're going to be standing toe-to-toe and firing a lot, so I want the Cyclonic. We're going to be Adrenaline rushing to get our shield back and hand-stolding our ground and shooting our gun a lot, so I like to have the Cyclonic. Nade capacity, you know, you could go the AR slash nade capacity equip gear bonus, but for me, I definitely just like to have a ton of grenades. These grenades are like nuclear bombs, guys. If you use them effectively, you're going to get a ton of points using these, a ton of kills using these. Assault rifle rail amp. Yeah, I recommend the Harrier. You know, remember, we have a shotgun as our sidearm, so it's like, you see what I'm saying, but you're primarily going to be doing damage with your AR. The Geth Plasma Shotgun, you're not going to have too much trouble taking out Phantom. It's a hell of a gun on its own merit. So, yeah. Okay, I don't have I'm trying to get every single character for you guys before this Andromeda drops, so I'm not going to have time to sit around and wait for teammates in the menu. We're probably going to go Ghost Reapers. Remember, you can use this setup against any possible, you know, faction. It'll do great. But, and all my builds, I normally do gold on own and own, but I just kind of like to pick maps that I haven't done yet, so you guys get variety. All right. I'll see you guys in the gameplay.
Thank you. Locality matrix. Power supply low. Recommend additional teammates in proximity. Low power. Recommend additional power for Omni tools. Additional Omni tools to be increased motor power.
agents didn't make it out. He dropped off his intel in a drone. Get it uploading.
Friendly forces detected.
Keep close or the drone will go dark again.
Low power restricts mobility. Recommend additional sources. Deorg system engaged.
I'm here!
three persons of interest in your area. Find those targets. You know what to do. Confirm kill. Enemy target has been marked. Targets are out of play. New enemy target in play.
Alright, guys, that was a really fucking fun game, man. Yeah, I will probably make you guys a video of this guy against Cerberus just because it plays so much different. But this is how you would play him against Reapers, Collectors, Geth. Just get the nades out and, you know, shoot. And remember, your adrenaline rush reloads your gun, as you saw in that gameplay. Yeah, so, this guy really, really wrecks. You just gotta... you know, find the choke points, find tons and tons of groups of enemies, nade the shit out of them, and then shoot everything else to death. And you drop enemies fast when you adrenaline rush and you start shooting them with this Harrier. It's really fast. And you'll see, if you look back in that gameplay, some of the time to kill that I got on Banshees and Brutes, I mean, it's just insane. So, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you next video.